Should be better now. There we go. Now we have sound. Now I have voice. I had sound, just no voice. So hopefully everybody's good on a Wednesday evening, and I'm fading myself out now against a white background. And I gotta work on. At some point, I have to look into a little better light than what I have, but right now, I don't have the money to look for a better light. But, trying to save for the new year and be a little better about spending. Which is why Game Pass and working through my backlog is probably going to be try to be my accomplishment for the year instead of buying a bunch of shit. Although, I already have Cyberpunk 2077 pre-ordered. And Tokyo Mirage Sessions FE Special Edition. I did those way last year when I had credit, so. And Game Pass, so I could get discounts. It also doesn't help that right now I'm going from a very hard white screen up there. So it's definitely showing off some of the fringe elements behind me that aren't quite getting enough light. And the other thing is I just use like little portable clip lights because I don't want to have to, part of me doesn't want to have to lug out like huge lights, set them up, then it just becomes a bigger deal to set up than it should be at that point.
And I'll be honest, unless you're making a ton of money, it doesn't make sense.
Indentured servants are freed. Anarchy soon. Was that at? Also, I don't like the fact that this game does have very long load times. Extremely long load times. It's a bit of an issue, but I guess it's just because of the size of the areas it's loading up, but
it's still a little annoying.
Oh man, excuse me. Yeah, I know. Yawns are already happening. What? Oh, it must be on that, the south side of Van Buren, where the, over by where the citrus fruit stand is. Because everything else on the north side is housing. Okay, so we are at Byzantium, and what are... Oh, we have... Pavarti has a level up. So what do we want to do? Chance to extract mods in the field. Yeah, let's go with that one, shall we? Or... go with that one, actually. So she can drop a little more damage. That's probably the better option. Anyways, I was looking to see whose quest I had.
We should probably...
let's not do that one yet, because I have a feeling that's going to end up pissing some people off. Okay. So first off, let's repair everything. Okay. Yeah, I already have something installed for that. And I have I have all that stuff installed too, so. What about armor mods? There we go. The Tinker. Tinker. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Go back. Tinker. And tinker some more, and tinker some more, tinker some more. Okay. Let's see. I'm trying to find a jewelry store. Weird, because this is supposed to look like a very rich, rich kind of place, but this is not looking very rich now, is it?
Nothing exciting ever happens around here.
Got it. Nothing ever happens exciting. Field.
Move along.
I tried.
Nothing exciting ever happens around here.
Ooh, I don't want that.
So what if those Amazites defeated on Monarch the whole time? I could do it. Easy.
Once I'm retired, I'm gonna drink all the zero G I can handle.
Can you believe I'm retiring?
Okay, why can't I get through the door? Okay, maybe that's why. I went the wrong way. I think we're okay now. Oh.
Why can't something exciting happen around here for once?
Nothing wrong with stability. It means everything's running like clockwork.
Don't you ever want a little fun? Maybe see a mirage ship get blown to bits overhead?
What a thing to say. Everyone knows mirage.
Janitor.
Hey, you.
Yeah, you.
Wanna be famous?
No, I want to pass you up first. We'll come back to you later.
To be a model of the system? Not super accurate. I once treated a lady who got her hand caught in the gears. Idiot was more worried about her rings than her fingers.
Billingsley House of Inebriation discovered. That's funny.
I've always loved that sculpture.
It's an orrery, and you say that every time.
A haberdashery.
Over here.
You with the hips over here.
Hold that posture for a moment while I admire you.
The less jolly.
You have a natural contrapposto, my dear. The way you rest your weight against your hip suggests a certain rugged charisma possessed only by the mighty primal and the well-traveled spacer. Splendid. I love it.
Yeah, the half lipstick thing is going weird. Me, rugged and well-traveled.
Ah, Celeste, you've done it again. I knew from the moment I laid eyes on you that I'd found my muse. I'm Celeste Jolicoeur, and you, my dear, are exactly what Byzantium needs. Darling, you and that brutish swagger of yours have been on my mind the moment you stepped into my studio. I'm
hey
working
then.
On a new line of clothing that will shock this city to its core, and I'd like your help. What do you say, my dear? Care to make history with me?
Sure.
Marvelous! You and I are gonna wake this city up like a cold splash of wine to the face.
Okay.
What I need is a survey of the outside world. What does the common laborer wear? How do the wild-eyed madmen of Monarch dress themselves? I've heard rumors, but I require samples. Also, I expect you to model for me.
Okay.
Oh, you cad. You'll be the talk of Byzantium once I'm done with you. I'll need you to model for me the following. The apparel of an iconoclast, the armor of a marauder, and a full ensemble of spacer gear, helmet included. And when I say spacer gear, I mean an outfit worn by real spacers. None of that garbage spacer's choice pedals. You have the bearing and demeanor of a born model. You're going to absolutely murder this job. I expect
okay.
You'll cut an exquisite figure. What else do you need to know? I've heard rumors of these iconoclasts, half-mad zealots rampaging across the surface of Monarch.
Okay.
You'll have to find your own way into Monarch. I can't help you. Even if I could, I prefer not to interfere.
Yeah, I've already completed Monarch, so that's going to be easy.
I don't know. I've never seen a marauder. Not in person, anyway. There are always Aetherwade programs, but I want something authentic. Byzantium is long overdue for a change of wardrobe, my dear. Something barbaric, yet elegant.
Barbaric, yet elegant. And she wants, like, real spacer gear.
If I were an enterprising spacer in need of a wardrobe, I'd probably head to the Groundbreaker.
I've just perfected an electronic hair bat analyzer which may hold the key to this baffling question.
I can't wait to see what you dredge up.
Hey, Alicat. How's it going? Thank you for hanging out. Okay.
Be so forward about my reasons, Captain.
Oh, come on.
Let me get a good look at you. Turn around, please, darling. My word. Such muscular shoulders. You're a vision, dear.
I am no such thing, ma'am.
Nonsense. You're absolutely lovely. Chin up now. I have
just the thing for you.
Let me do a back of the envelope calculation. Materials, labor, licensing, and copyright. There.
Hmm. Let's persuade.
Love. That's the ultimate luxury, darling. Love. Oh, gracious me.
I don't get why that's funny, ma'am.
Oh, my cherub. Who woos for love anymore?
Wow. Oh,
precious. All right, Captain. Here is the absolute best I can do for you. There are some things I simply cannot skimp on, darling. Such a lovely
That's all right.
young lady deserves the best. Now stand back. Back, back. I'll enter the settings and get these machines spinning. You'll be broke to bespoke in merely an hour.
Okay.
And there we are, my darling girl. I wish you a splendiferous evening. And if you don't mind my asking, have you any interest in modeling?
What? Oh, no, ma'am. All them eyes staring at me? I couldn't. No way, no how. I get scared just thinking on it.
I wish you weren't so shy, my Violet. You truly are beautiful.
I hope your date sees that as clear as I. God.
I can't wait to see those outfits.
Yeah, well, I was trying to trade with you and it went away. There it is. Oh man, excuse me. All right, so okay. So we got the dress. Oh. Bonk.
Oh, can you believe this outfit? It's so handsome, I'm almost afraid to touch it. Well, I guess that's everything then. After all this time. I just have to actually do it now.
Yep.
You know, there's a part Junlei's been looking for. To fix up the air cyclers? They only carried them on big colony ships, like the Hope. I know. For a while, it felt like everything I did was a little bit of help. And it meant I didn't have to ask her to be mine. Not yet. Not for real. Next time we dock with Groundbreaker, I'm doing it. I'll send June a message and ask her over.
There you go.
Scary, Captain. I'm grateful for all you done.
Okay. Well, we're not leaving here yet, so. Hey.
Okay. I love Byzantium. Where else are you going?
I'll make you famous, kid. It's the bar.
Today marks a monumentous occasion in the course of Halcyon.
Okay, where is this place we gotta go?
Sure, they look fancy, but inside there's marble and existential emptiness. There's my parents' place. Smell that? Industrial grade cleaning solvent and desperation.
Wow. She seems very adamant on not enjoying her parents' hospitality. Ugh.
you?
Laws, we certainly didn't expect to see you like this.
And I didn't expect you to renew your marriage contract. But we're all full of surprises today, aren't we?
Wow.
Speaking of surprises, you should meet my new friend. We've been running around the system for a while now, stirring up all sorts of trouble.
Play the ruffian angle some more. You're supposed to help me make an impression.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, you're probably wondering where I've been all this time.
That's right.
Not exactly.
The last few years have been a bloody haze. You wouldn't believe the mess.
That's right. She wants me to be like...
Right? Yep, we're a pair of disgraceful lowlifes.
Marilyn, this really isn't the best time.
Wow. Is she just trying to get a rise out of her parents?
You tell him. We'll stay as long as we like. And while we're at it, we'll drink your expensive hooch, wear our outside shoes all over your nice floors.
Huh.
Just a second. You had the floors redone with real Terran marble? Since when can you afford that?
That's what we've been trying to tell you, dear, but you must understand.
Oh no, did they have her declared dead?
We thought you were dead.
I'm not dead. I just never wanted to talk to you again.
I'm afraid the distinction was lost on us, darling.
We only did what any grieving parents in our position would do. We collected on your life insurance policy.
And the payouts have been rather, substantial.
Oh my god.
You what? Well, now that I'm here, I guess you'll just have to report back that I'm very much alive and kicking.
It's not that simple. For one thing, we'd have to cut back on so many necessities. The neighbors would be sure to notice.
Yep.
That's the other problem.
We had to explain your disappearance somehow.
We couldn't very well tell people you'd run off to become a miscreant, could we? Shh. Someone could hear you.
Yep, that's
we
the point.
We concocted a story about Celeste Jolly Girl designing a pair of
12-inch heels. Jesus Christ.
That led to your tragic death when you tripped and broke your neck.
Quite the story. People were talking about it for weeks.
Not until I get some answers.
Okay.
Couldn't you have at least made up a better story? Something with pirates or raptodons? And what are you gonna do now that we're here?
Mm. Yes, about that. We were just about to ask you to, leave.
Wow.
Quietly.
Their own daughter.
Well, we're trying to avoid further embarrassment.
I'm afraid it would cause quite a stir if the neighbors saw you two stomping about.
Oh, we should...
That's it? You just want us to disappear now?
Marilyn, please.
Don't cause a scene.
Let's just get out of here, Captain. Fine. I'm gone. Forever this time.
Wow.
Let's talk outside.
Okay. How do I get outside? Oh, here. Help the chairman and Minister Clark. Our foes. That's not gonna happen. Boy, man. Her parents were a bunch of dicks. Oh, we thought you were dead. We collected on the old life insurance policy. Sorry. Okay.
Captain, got a minute?
Yeah, let me put my gun away before I accidentally shoot somebody.
Can you believe those two?
We've yeah.
We've been there a minute and they turned us out like yesterday's garbage. I thought they'd be scandalized. They'd both be sitting there watching one of their vapid aetherwave dramas, and then we'd walk in. Mother would drop her mock apple cider, and the glass would shatter all over their overpriced marble. Father would tear off glasses and blink open mouth.
You'll come. It's a very specific fantasy.
I'm getting to the good part. I'd have a great one-liner in the tube. I was thinking either the leather's fake, but the scars are real, or oops, did I just track awesome onto your rug?
Wow.
Yeah, I'm gonna use that one day. Now, getting back to my story. Father would throw his hands up because this would be just like me to come back and make a big scene.
Make a big scene.
Then mother would do the old, you had us worried sick. Her eyes would be red and she'd have her fist in front of her mouth to stifle a sob.
This seems like something you really want.
I'm not hurt. I'm outraged. Affronted, even. I just didn't want to get booted out of the house I grew up in like that. It's embarrassing, you know. And I've got a reputation to maintain. I'm used to rough situations.
Like
when someone loads your pistol with blanks and strands you in a Marauder moon base, or traps you in an airlock with an angry mantis worm.
Ouch.
But I want to talk about me now.
Hey, talk about you.
Unless you mean the kind who look out for you to blink so they could swipe your bits. The galaxy's not exactly crawling with those.
Jesus, lady.
I don't want to sift through this lousy experience for meaningful life lessons. I'm mad. And
I want to do something about it.
Something like, wait a second. What if I could get that money?
Uh-oh.
Let's look at this as an advance on my dying eventually. Besides, if anyone deserves to profit off my death, it's me. I could open a new account, designate that account holder as a sole beneficiary. All the payouts would go to me.
Like a plan.
Without doing a thing. And I'll get to cut them off. My policy is with the Greater Halcyon Insurance Group. They have an office in Byzantium.
Okay.
Maybe you could use some of your people skills to help me set up a dummy beneficiary account. If that doesn't work, I'm sure we can find one of their terminals and do it ourselves.
No, I bet you I could convince somebody. Let's go. Come on, Ellie.
Miss Ellie, Dr. Finhill. I noticed your pistol's been making a funny noise.
What are you talking about? I oil it every night.
Well, look here. Your slide's not recoiling fully. You might be due for a new spring. I could take a look, maybe fix it for you.
Sure. I'm sure.
Oh, this isn't good.
I'll pay you back.
Oh, no. I mean, it don't cost nothing. I got a spare spring in my pocket here, even.
Everything's got a price.
You saw a letter in the mailbox, Tress.
I guess we're going to Fallbrook.
Oh, okay. That was easy enough. Yeah. Alright, well, we're not leaving here yet. We'll go here. Next. Oh, now we get to go back to where we were at. Oh, man.
Take real good care of your pistol, Dr. Fenhill.
I oughta. Kept me alive this long.
I mean, you treat it nice. Makes me happy to see, because I feel the same way about my wrench.
Look, it's a tool that does a job. Feelings got nothing to do with it.
Okay, so we were able to get in without any shooty-shooty, which is good. Walked right through the front door, no problems, no haggles, no questions asked. Oh man, I hate it when I. All right, hold on, I'm gonna step away just for a second, so. Hey, everybody. We're back. Sorry about that. I needed, like, a snack. You know, I figured I was feeling a little sleepy, so I'd get a snack and a soda. Since I drank my 96 ounces of water for the day now, and I feel like I'm about to float. Okay.
This reminds me of... Oh, never mind.
Oh, downstairs. Huh. I don't know if I like this. Sealed. Terminal. Let's read the logs. I read a message that an unauthorized user was looking through the files on my Cascadia terminal. Maybe some marauder with two firing brain cells, maybe not. Whoa. Wow. That sounds... Political instability pulled Cascadia out from under me, and some combination of cabin fever and paranoia soured HRS 1084. Perhaps my home in steadfast Byzantium will offer the retreat I need. Ever since our species became aware of itself, we've imposed superiority, but our rule of strength didn't work and a Halcyon did it. There we go. Labs unsealed. Take a ride. I have a feeling something's going to be released and it's not going to make me happy.
Wow, look at the size of this basement. If someone back home wanted to make a secret lab, they'd have to put it in a closet.
That's far enough. What are you doing here? How did you even get inside?
That's for us to know.
If anyone ever tries to off me, I hope they do it with the same professional courtesy.
Hagen? I've never heard of her. Is she from the board? Damn it. I knew this would happen.
That's a gentlewomanly way of putting it, Captain. She's obsessed with aliens.
She's obsessed with aliens. Very obsessed.
I've never even been to Groundbreaker. What happened to the team? Tell me you didn't move their suspension tanks.
No.
Small consolation. My team, the finest minds,
reduced to salvage. Which, oh, you're putting your glasses back out here. What were they trying to prove by experimenting on themselves?
That the colony could survive the crisis bearing down on us.
What? What crisis?
What are you doing, Doctor? This information is beyond classified.
You could write me up in your report. It hardly matters. I'm researching a new way to feed the colony. The crops we transplanted from Earth don't give us the nutrients we need. Our colonists might not realize it yet, but they're starving.
Huh.
The food we grow here barely sustains human life. The colony won't last under these conditions. So, the board let me approach the problem from a different angle.
Okay.
I believe that I could adapt humans to live on Halcyon's terms. That I could change us. Give us the ability to derive sustenance from the nutrients the food does have. Not for lack of trying. I wanted to save them all, but I wasn't strong enough. I wouldn't allow us to experiment on convicts or the unemployed. It's wrong, no matter what the law says.
Everyone agreed we accept the risk. Okay, well that's noble.
I'm desperate. I've already asked all the best institutes on Earth for help. Years ago, we sent a message out on the Cornelius Vanderbilt, but heard nothing back.
Okay.
It's been missing for over 2 years now. They never reestablished contact after the skip to Earth. Of course, the board is keeping that under wraps.
Hey.
Losing something with that many guns on it. How'd you lose half a pair of ships like it were a sock?
The board is uneasy about letting the colony know, seeing as half of their military force vanished without a trace.
Hey.
I'd prefer if you didn't use my name when you talk about this. My contract has a list of very terrible consequences.
You just said you didn't care.
Once we can replicate a success, the board will move to rewire our nucleon. With any luck, our next generation will be eating and thriving off Halcyon crops.
Knowing what the board considers a success, that doesn't give me a lot of hope.
Yeah, no shit.
You really think the board got our best interests at heart? I mean, they say, but I'm just not sure.
We haven't made enough strides to advance the plan. Hardly any at all. But we have to keep trying. You came to kill me. I assume that's still on the table. Please don't. If I die, there's no one who can reproduce our work. Every sacrifice will have been for nothing. And we'll be no closer to a solution that feeds the colony.
It seems like she's trying to help, Captain. Honest help. Ain't many in the colony doing that. We should let her try.
I hope you know what you're doing, Captain. I leave it in your hands.
Well, what's Ellie think?
I try not to, least when it comes to the moral dilemmas. Lilia Hagen's a useful ally to have, but I'll back you up either way.
Everything I did was for the good of the colony. Consider that.
That's our...
Ah!
Come on, get up. Well, I'm sorry, but she couldn't be trusted. She was an asshole. I know the board's not going to be happy with me, but the board can go suck it. Where is she? Oh, she's down here. Let's see. No, it's any center. No, I did not like what she did, man. She was bad. She was very bad. I understand that she feels her goals were noble, but okay, so okay, let us escape out the front door. Not too shabby, if you ask me. It does seem to be a slow night on the Twitch. That's all right. I'm probably only going to stream for about another 5 or 10 minutes, and then I'm probably going to not go to bed, but I just want some unwind time. I got a lot on my plate right now that I'm trying to figure out, so seems like the last 2 weeks have just been so fucking busy. Okay, we're here.
I've seen a lot of the colony, huh, Dr. Fenhill?
Ellie. And sure, but most of it looks the same from inside a ship.
Sorry, Dr. Ellie. Still, though, don't you find it thrilling, being in space?
Look, it's just Ellie.
Okay.
Personal detail, and that means you gotta keep 5 feet back at all times. Yep, you're looking at the minister's newest personal guard, right here. The others took me out to celebrate on account of me just getting hired and all.
Oh boy, this is gonna go bad for this guy.
He's basically the most important person in the colony, which makes me the most important guard in the colony.
Well, this guy's gonna make a mistake
that
here very soon.
The minister- minister's estate, my own personal UDL issued shotgun. They don't give those out to just anyone. That's right. Not just anyone is allowed to have a key to Minister Clark's residence. It's all very high level. That's a great idea. I'll have a Spectrum vodka.
Captain, I can smell him from clear over here. I reckon he's had a fair number already.
Sure have, because
today's my big day. We're going to get him fired.
Well, good ears, too.
Powerful thirst. You have a Spectrum vodka for a new pal? Cheers to me. Hey, you're really great. Have I told you that? We should be friends. Wow, listen to me. I'm soaked. I should probably slow down before I'm face down on the tile somewhere.
Oh, no, you'll be fine.
Who am I kidding? I could have another. You got another?
I probably do.
Oh, maybe they got some at the bar.
Have you? Then you'll want to speak with our.
Oh, okay. Yeah, see, that's why I said I'm starting to zone the fuck out.
Please allow me to improve your drinking experience.
So, let's, I just want to kind of... Might as well load up.
Hey, you look familiar. Have we met before? It's not every day you get your dream job, right? Wow, you've got like this crazy energy. Has anyone ever told you that? You're like a manosaur. You got a manosaur energy.
Got a manosaur.
I gotta stop. I'm seeing at least two of them. I really shouldn't. I'll have the worst hangover tomorrow if I don't stop.
Nonsense. You've got another in you.
Doctor's orders.
Yes, I can't do that.
This guy.
Yeah. Was that one supposed to taste like Purpleberry Crunch?
Oh, excuse me.
Tasting breakfast. I don't feel so good. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Did he just die? Did we kill him?
Nice thing about traveling with the captain. We meet all sorts of new people.
Sure. Best part is when they pay us.
We never really had new folks in Edgewater, except the captain. Kind of hard to make new friends when everyone's already decided they don't like you.
Could be a favor in disguise. A lot of people out here ain't that nice.
Okay. We're gonna go ahead and save it. We're right in front of there. That'll be good for us on the next point. Yeah, just, man, I'm just hungry. I didn't eat a huge dinner, so... I think that's why I got a case of the yawn, so... Anyways, we'll be back on tomorrow night to, not tomorrow night, Friday night. And we'll see what we can do. Figure something out. Thanks everybody for stopping by. Alley Cat, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for lurking around. That's always awesome. I'm glad that you were able to stop by. And I think that's going to be it for the evening. Again, like I said, I'll be back on Friday night. So until then, bye.